Now, generally speaking, I don't buy the variations, the other extensions. So let's say .org, .net. So for in that example, I would buy friendlydog.com, org, net, and info spelled properly. And then I would buy the .com version of the misspelled one for Friendly Dog. Because people aren't really going to try to build on a misspelled website. But you do want to capture that traffic if someone spells it incorrectly. That would be a total of, let's say, so $10 for the one domain name and $30 for the three. If you think you can set up a website for cheaper than that, go for it. And let me know how you're going to do it effectively. But you need to own the domain names for a couple of reasons, not the least of which is credibility. And secondarily, it's how you're going to have a custom email address associated with your domain. Flash forward, let's assume that you've gone and you've purchased that domain name, okay? Let's say that that domain name is thefriendlydog.com. Okay, you've purchased that. Now what you need to do is go in to your account. And again, I would keep in that folder that we were talking about, you want to keep what's your login information, your username, your password to get into your domain account. Keep that stuff written down, because as you go forward in business, stuff just moves so quickly that if you don't have access to it, quick access, you're just not going to do it. You're going to move on and do something else. So save yourself that trouble right now and write all that stuff down in one place. You're logged in. And what you need to do is go to, if you're on any of these platforms, it doesn't matter, you're going to see a link that's going to say email account. From left to right, it'll say like domains, hosting, email accounts, and then, you know, right on across. What you're looking for is one that says email accounts. Go in there and you're going to set up, once you purchase a domain name, if you do it on my reseller, the small business domains and hosting.com, it's going to come with a free email account. Do not buy another, you know, email package. You do not need any of that. Do not buy hosting. You do not need any of that. Just purchase the domain. That's it. Log in, go to email accounts. And once you're there, you're going to have to set up your free account. I'm going to click the email and then the setup button. And what you're going to do there is it's going to say you have a free credit. Click that and you're going to click setup, okay? And then it's going to ask you which domain you want to associate to. I'll assume for the purposes of this video that you only have the one. You're going to click the domain friendlydog.com. Then what you're going to do is you're going to go in after it's set up, which is probably going to take about 60 seconds for it to populate through the system. Then you're going to go back into email accounts and click the launch button. And once you're in there, you're gonna click edit. See a little line, and then you'll see like a little pencil mark. It looks like a little pencil over here. And you wanna click that because that's the edit button. Once you are in there, these are the things that you want to do. You want to open that screen up. And by the way, when you are setting up your email address, use info at whatever your domain name is, .com. Again, let's use Friendly Dog. Info at friendlydog.com. Now, some people will tell you to do it differently. I'm going to tell you to do it that way, and here's why. Number one, I've been in business either for myself or as an executive for over 20 years, and I have seen this situation go wrong so many times. I actually have another YouTube video, which I'll put the link right there, and it talks about, you know, why you should have a custom email address to your domain name. But what you really want to do here is, let's ask ourselves this question. Why are you bothering with this at all, right? The reason that you're doing the custom email to associate it to your domain name is credibility, right? You want to look credible and you want to be able to be found and reached easily. Actually, someone just asked me this the other day, and I'll keep their name anonymous, but let's say that, you know, it is Sally at friendlydog.com. Well, that's great. We met at a networking event or whatever, and she's a dog sitter, and I remember it's Friendly Dog. I think her name's Sally. Okay, Sally. Yeah, all right. I sit down and I go to compose an email. Sally at friendlydog.com. Okay, let's assume that Sally's name is spelled S-A-L-L-Y at friendlydog.com. But I think, because I have a friend named Sally who spells it S-A-L-L-I-E, that's how it should be spelled. So what do? I send an email to sallie@friendlydog.com. Now, what happens? Well, I, the sender, am gonna get back a note that says, sorry, unavailable, kicked back. And I'm gonna be thinking to myself, well, wait a minute, I know that's what she said her name was. I don't know, maybe they're out of business and I'm never gonna bother with it again. Okay, so that's scenario one. Scenario two, the preferred scenario, is that, you could do a couple things here. If you wanna use your own personal name, if you know that you're gonna be a one person operation forever, then you can use your name. You can say sallie@friendlydog.com. That's fine. But what you absolutely must do is click the little button when you're setting up your email account that says, make this a catch-all. What does that do? Here's what it does. This is simple and it's magic. And I would have missed, I don't even know how many contacts without this. What it does is, you could send an email to, pizzastone@friendlydog.com or, kitchenaid@friendlydog.com. And there you go. You're still going to receive that email. Why? Because you made it a catch-all, which means it's going to catch all of the names forward of the @ sign and it's going to send all of it to you. So that is super important. If you are going to use your name, make it a catch-all. I don't personally like the concept of using an individual name when I'm starting a business. The reason for that is I don't wanna have to redo all of my marketing materials. If I'm setting up emails for certain people that may or may not work for the company, maybe they are contractors or something, I just like info because everybody can remember that. It just seems, it gives a more polished presence. Now, when you're down the road, you're the president of the company, you have 10 employees, you want to hand your card out with your own personal email address, go for it. Because then that makes it seem like, hey, everybody else has to use info@, but for you, you can use my personal email address. Say that you decide, I don't want to use my own name. I want to go the info route. Then you're going to do the exact same thing, okay? You're going to log in, you're going to click the setup, you're going to go in, you're going to click, make this a catch-all. Okay, that's the first thing that you're gonna do. Are you gonna forward it? Second question is, are you gonna check it on the server, which means where you are currently logged in, basically, or are you gonna forward it to your phone or to your entourage, all the rest of that? Now, again, I have some opinions here, and this is just years and years and years of experience. I used Entourage forever. And I was a big fan of Entourage for a really long time. But then let me tell you what happened. When we had two locations, okay? So I had one in one city and one in another, and I was going back and forth between the two. Here's what would happen. Someone would send me an email at 3:00 in the afternoon, which I would check and be able to pull in on my phone, but I couldn't respond to them because I didn't have a signature set up, or it was going to one side and then I couldn't see it from the other, or I had saved it in a file on this one and not. Let me just help you go around that right now. Use the server that is available to you through wherever you purchase your domain name. I am doing that now and it has made my life exponentially more simple. So now it forwards direct to my iPhone or my iPad, and if I delete from any of those locations, I've gotten in and set up the settings so that it deletes it from the server. We'll talk about that in another video. Okay, so going back, if you're gonna forward it, a lot of people in the beginning will do that because they don't wanna have to check two email locations, and that's fine if you wanna do that. As long as that other one is something that is also internet-based. That's just my only, take that for whatever it's worth. If it's another one, which is, so-and-so at, so let's say, sallie@friendlydog.com wants to forward it to, sallysunday@yahoo.com because that's her full name, that's fine, go for it, do that. So just click the forward and then enter that email address, okay? The only problem with that is when you check from, SallySunday@yahoo.com and you reply back, it's not coming back to your customer from Sally@friendlydog.com. It's coming back from SallySunday@yahoo.com. Now, if you are like me, and I receive these emails all the time, and I honestly find them laughable. When people send, and it happens all the time when you have a website, you know, this SEO expert or this marketing person, you know, they've done an analysis of my website and they want to tell us why, you know, this could be improved, blah, 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 blah. And then their name is, you know, frankrogers@gmail.com. Okay, well, let me stop you right there. I'm never going to respond to you because if you have a Gmail account, you don't take yourself seriously, in my opinion, and certainly not seriously enough to be evaluating my brand. That's not a vendor I would ever do business with. Now, is that to say that you'll never be taken seriously if you use a, you know, basically a common email server? No, but it is to say that people will take you more seriously if you use your domain name email. That's just a fact. If we were out, and I kind of touch on this on my other video, we're out at the park, okay? And I'm walking my dog, and you're walking your dog, and I'm going out of town next week, and friendlydog.com is a pet sitting service. If you and I are chatting it up, and you know, I love you and think, I want to use this lady next week when I go out of town, and then you tell me that your email address is SallySunday@Yahoo, all of a sudden, I'm thinking, I don't know. Whereas, if you told me that your email address is info@friendlydog.com, I'm not gonna give it a second thought. I'm gonna think this is someone who is in business and established. I'm gonna shoot an email to you and I'm gonna use you next week.